Prior to the virus outbreak, the trade dispute between the U.S. and China disrupted supply chains in a way Alex Capri of Hinrich Foundation says placed both nations in a completely different space in parallel universes, tariffs on the one side and then U.S.-China tech war on the other. So how then does the virus outbreak come into play, impacting already disrupted supply chains? With us now for more is Alex Capri, the research fellow at Hinrich Foundation, an expert on supply chains based in Singapore. Good to have you with us, Alex. Welcome to the program.
Thank you.
So the trade war is now overshadowed by the virus outbreak. What now for the supply chains already disrupted by the U.S.-China trade war? Factories there serving overseas clients are still on an extended holiday because of the outbreak.
Yeah, so this is just another disruption to already disrupted supply chains for the factors you've mentioned already. And I think this potentially, depending on how long this goes, could really have a material effect on global value chains. I mean, just yesterday, Hyundai announced that they were suspending production on a major line. This is outside of China because they weren't able to get parts and components on a timely, as-needed basis. And that's because one of the side effects of this coronavirus is that airlines have dramatically cut back travel in and out of China. And, you know, those airlines carry a lot of air freight. So that's one factor. I think another is if you look at any capital-intensive, very complex industry, such as automotive or technology, which you've mentioned, those industries have thousands of parts and components that they're moving around across borders, and some of those components cross a border two or three times before they're finally in their finished form. So you can imagine, you know, as China becomes more and more of a manufacturing hub, as it becomes more deeply integrated in global value chains, that something of this nature, this coronavirus, could really start having a material impact that already is.
So how much of a material impact, Alex, when you compare that to the U.S.-China trade war and how that's already disrupted the supply chains? I mean, they've already moved to ASEAN hubs such as Vietnam, Indonesia, and Thailand. So there is a greater exposure because of the slowdown.
Well, it depends on the industry. In your lead-in, you mentioned the tech rivalry between the U.S. and China. That is a long-term issue. So that's going to be around, you know, months and even years from now. And this phenomenon of techno-nationalism, is something that's going to continue to influence global supply chains in the technology industry, where we will continue to see decoupling. So that's a long-term event. The coronavirus, though, could have a much more broad impact on a broad swathe of industries. And we don't know how long that's going to last. But that, as I mentioned earlier, that is just yet another complication in global supply chains.
It is, and presumably global demand shifting towards the non-discretionary, such as masks, protective gear, health-related products and services. So where does that place demand for tech? I mean, could people put off purchases, perhaps, of a new phone or gadget? And what is that going to mean for demand to produce them? Or does that shift demand to biotech?
Yeah, no, that's already happening. So Apple has had to close their stores, throughout in China because people are just not going in and buying. Obviously, Starbucks is having a similar situation. So retail is already taking a huge hit, not to mention, of course, the travel industry, hotels, et cetera. This is really having a knock-on effect across a broad range of sectors.
So what then, Alex, could the implications be of what you saw as a bifurcation of the tariffs on the one hand and then tech trade war on the other? You see semiconductors as really the ground zero of the conflict, the key components for new age tech.
Yeah, so again, any kind of technologies that have so-called dual use or national security implications are going to be in play, in this systemic rivalry between China and the U.S. Going forward. So, tariffs are one issue, but non-tariff measures such as export controls, sanctions, or another, and those will continue. So those will continue to define the relationship going forward, the trading relationship. So again, those are, as I said, and as you've mentioned, those are two completely different planes or universes. But again, if we're going to be throwing in other disruptors, such as, you know, viruses or potential pandemics, you know, that's the perfect storm. That is potentially going to have an effect on the entire global economy.